a very warm good morning to one and all. So how are you children? I hope that you all are fit and fine at home. Children, I am very anticipating that you all must be doing quite well. So let's start today's lecture. So first of all children, in last video we have completed social and political life chapter 4, that is growing up as boys and girls, right? So in this video we are going to start geography chapter 4, that is AM, and this is part 1. So in part 1, first we understand the composition of air, then after that we will discuss the important layers of the atmosphere one by one. But before moving further, students, be ready with your rough notebook and pen to note down the important point that we have discussed in this video. So let's start. Children, as you know, our Earth is a unique planet. Why our Earth is a unique planet? The presence of atmosphere. The presence of atmosphere has helped to make it so. Now, what is atmosphere? What is atmosphere? A huge blanket of air. Atmosphere means a huge blanket of air. Now just tell me, why is it called a blanket? Why is it called a blanket? That's because not just does the atmosphere provide us air that we breathe, but it also protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. Without this blanket of protection, the day would have been burning hot and the night would be freezing cold. So it is the atmosphere that moderates the temperature and make it livable for us. Clear? Second thing is the word atmosphere. The word atmosphere is derived from the Greek word. First one is the atmos. Atmos means vapor. And second one is the sphere. That means air between the Earth's surface and the outer space. Clear? Now move on to the next is, children, do you know the air we take in while we breathe, actually it's actually a mixture of many gases. As you know, most atmospheric air constitute, first is nitrogen. Nitrogen 78%. Second is oxygen. Oxygen, not 20, actually it's 21%, right? Nitrogen 78%, oxygen 21%, and rest of the 1% include carbon dioxide, helium, hydrogen, etc. etc. So basically this pie chart gives you the percentage of different constituent of air. Is it clear? This pie chart basically gives you the percentage of the different constituent of air. So first one is the nitrogen 78%, then oxygen 21%, and 1% include carbon dioxide, argon, helium, hydrogen. And apart from this, impurities like dust, smoke, carbon monoxide also present in the atmosphere. Even the lower layer of the atmosphere also contain water vapor. Water vapor. Clear? So these two gases, nitrogen and oxygen, these two gases make up bulk of the atmosphere, and the rest of the gases, carbon dioxide, helium, hydrogen, argon, are found in lesser quantity. Now let's understand the importance of these gases into the atmosphere. First one is the nitrogen. Nitrogen is the most plentiful gas in the atmosphere, right? 78%. This gas is very essential for the survival and the growth of plants. Do you know, children, plants basically cannot take a nitrogen directly from the air. So the bacteria that live in soil and root of some plants, they take nitrogen from the air and change its form, right? So that plant can use it. Basically, plant observe nitrogen through the soil for their growth and development. Clear? So nitrogen is the most important and it is the most plentiful gas in the atmosphere. Second is oxygen. Oxygen is the second most plentiful gas in the atmosphere, 21%. Human beings take oxygen from the atmosphere that we breathe. So the green plant produce oxygen during the photosynthesis, during the process of photosynthesis. So in this way, oxygen content remain constant in the atmosphere. And this is very important for the survival of the human beings on the earth's surface. So if we cut trees, so it get disturbed. So the balance get disturbed, right? Okay, now the next is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is also an important gas in the atmosphere. Green plant. Green plant basically use carbon dioxide to make their food and release oxygen. And human beings release carbon dioxide. So the amount of carbon dioxide released by the human seems equals to the amount used by the plant, which make the perfect balance. But however, the balance get disturbed by burning fuels such as coal and oil, and this add billions of tons of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. As resulting, if the level of the carbon dioxide increase in the atmosphere, right, it change earth climate and weather. Basically, carbon dioxide create greenhouse effect by trapping the heat radiated from the earth. The term greenhouse effect and global warming, it's directly linked to the carbon dioxide. As the level of carbon dioxide increase in the atmosphere, it resulting changes in the earth's climate and weather. Clear? So carbon dioxide observes by the plant and released by the human beings and animals. Now, do you know, children, when air heat up, so it become lighter, right? When air heat up, it become lighter and expand and goes up. And cold air is denser and heavy. So that is why it tends to sink down. So when hot air rises, so the cold air from surrounding area rushes there to fill in the gap. So that is how the air circulation takes place in the atmosphere. Just note on this point, like when the air heat up, it become lighter and the cold air is denser and heavy. Now the next topic is structure of the atmosphere. So first of all, the atmosphere is extend up to 1600 kilometer from the earth's surface. Clear? The atmosphere is extend up to 1600 kilometer from the earth's surface. If we talk about the density of the air, so the density of the air is various at different places. Basically, it is highest near the sea level and become lesser, move further away from the earth's surface. So on the basis of composition, temperature and other properties, atmosphere is divided into the five layers. Clear? The atmosphere on the basis of composition, temperature, atmosphere is divided into the five layers. These are the five layers. First one is troposphere. Second is stratosphere. Third one is the mesosphere. Fourth one is thermosphere. And the fifth one is the exosphere. Clear? So basically, there are five layers of the atmosphere: troposphere, After that, atmosphere, then mesosphere, thermosphere, and the last one is the exosphere. Now let's understand all these layers one by one. So let's start with the first, troposphere. Troposphere, first of all, it's the lowest and the most important layer of the atmosphere. Now, its average height is 13 kilometer. Basically, it's about 8 kilometer at the pole and 18 kilometer at the equator. Next thing is, this layer is closest to the earth. So this is the densest layer of the atmosphere. All the weather phenomena, like almost all the weather phenomena, like the rainfall, fog, lightning, thundering, hailstorm, occur in this layer. Now the next thing is, temperature decrease with the height increase, right? Temperature decrease with the height increase at the rate of 1 degree Celsius for every 165 kilometer, and this is known as the normal lapse rate. That means temperature decrease with height increase at the rate of 1 degree Celsius. Now the uppermost edge of this layer, that means the troposphere layer, is tropopause, and beyond this tropopause, temperature stop decreasing. As I said, troposphere is the most important layer of the atmosphere. Why? Because this layer absorbs maximum heat and protect us from the excessive heat throughout the day, and also maintain the level of the temperature at night. Now move on to the next layer, second layer, stratosphere. This layer lies just above the troposphere. This is the second important layer of the atmosphere. The temperature in the lower part of this layer is constant, but gradual changes is occurred in the upper part of this layer. This layer is contain ozone, and as we know that ozone that protect us from the ultraviolet rays of the sun. This layer is being free from cloud zone. Basically, this is the cloud free zone. No weather phenomena occur in this zone, in this area. So that's why this layer is ideal for the jet flying, right? No weather phenomena occur in this layer. So this is ideal for the jet flying. Now the next one is mesosphere. The third important layer of the atmosphere, it lies just above the stratosphere. Now it extends up to the height of 80 kilometer. Basically, in this layer, temperature decrease at the height increase, and it almost reach 100 degree Celsius. Almost 100 degree Celsius, minus 100 degree Celsius. Now the most important thing about the mesosphere, meteoroids burn in this layer as they enter from the space. Now the next one is thermosphere. Is the fourth layer of the atmosphere. It is also very important. In the thermosphere, temperature rises very rapidly with increasing height. Just note down this point. In this layer, that means in thermosphere, temperature rises very rapidly with the increasing height. Right. Second thing is this. It extends between 80 to 400 kilometer. This layer contain ionos. Right. This layer contain ionos, which a particle reflects the radio waves back to the earth and enable wireless communication on the earth's surface. So this is also known as the ionosphere because the presence of ionos. Now the last one is the uppermost layer of the atmosphere, is known as exosphere, and this layer is extend up to the 1600 kilometer and merge with the interplanetary space. Now this layer has very thin air. Light gases like the helium, hydrogen float into the space from here. So these are the important five layers of the atmosphere. Like first one is the troposphere. Troposphere is the most important layer of the atmosphere. All the weather phenomena occur in this layer. Second is the stratosphere. Basically, this is cloud-free zone, so no weather phenomena occur here. So this layer is ideal for the jet flying. Now after stratosphere, next one is the mesosphere. Basically, mesosphere, all the meteoroids burn in this layer as they enter from the space. And the next one is the thermosphere. It is also known as the ionosphere because the presence of the ions. And the last one is the exosphere, that means the uppermost layer of the atmosphere. Clear? Now next is significance of the atmosphere. The atmosphere is of great significance of the earth. Like first, how it act as a blanket and protect us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. Second thing is the carbon dioxide that help the plants to produce their own food. That next one is it helps in keeping the earth by absorbing heat. The presence of oxygen and nitrogen is essential for the survival and the growth of animals and the plant life. And the last one is the water vapor in the atmosphere leads to precipitation and influences weather and climatic condition. So that's it for this part. Rest of the topic we will discuss in the next video. Now quiz time. So the first question is the gas which is important for the growth of plant is dash. Options are, first one is ozone, second option is nitrogen, and the third option is oxygen. Now just tell me which gas is important for the growth of plant. Yes, option B, nitrogen. Nitrogen is very essential and important for the survival and the growth of plants. Second question, the layer in which all weather related phenomena take place is dash. Options are, first one is exosphere, second one is the troposphere, and the third one is stratosphere. Now just tell me which layer is basically in which layer all the weather phenomena occur. In the first layer of the atmosphere, that means option B, troposphere. In this layer all the weather phenomena occur take place, like the rainfall, fog, hailstorm, thundering and lightning. Now the next question is question number 3. Our atmosphere is divided into dash layers. So in how many layers our atmosphere is divided? 5 layers. First one is the troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and the last one is the exosphere. Our atmosphere is divided into the 5 layers. Next one is the 4th. Green plants produce oxygen during the process of dash. So green plant produce oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, right? So green plants produce oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. Now move on to the next one, question number 5th. Meteoroids burn off in dash on entering from the space. So in which layer meteoroids burn when it's enter from the space? Mesosphere, right? In mesosphere it's burn up. Now the 6th question is, one important feature of the stratosphere is that it contain a layer of dash gas. So it contain a layer of ozone gas. clear? So that's all for today. Have a nice day, children. Thank you.